we are called this angle we are denoting small r. Why we are denoting small r means here the total sentence is started. What is the first letter here? R. Due to that we are denoting here small r. So this line and this line, how much angle making? I. Again this line and this line, how much is making? R. So this is I, this is R. That's why we are calling this is the incident angle. Again this is calling reflection angle. That's why for us they have given two rules. Or this, if it is like this, then we can say reflection of loss. What we can say? Reflection of loss. Okay, sound also this loss will be there, but we are discussing here in the optics. Reflection of loss or loss of reflection we can say. Okay, there are in the physics, there are in the optics, there are two laws are there. Two laws of reflection will be there. What is the first one? Angle of incident is equal to angle of R. Okay, you may denote capital I also or capital R also, no problem. Okay, from the 26 alphabet you can consider any alphabet. Why I consider I means this is the first letter of incident. Why I consider R means this is the first letter of reflection. Due to that I consider angle of I is equal to angle of R. Next one, this is the first law, angle of incident is equal to angle of R. So let us take the, if it is 30 degrees, definitely this also 30 degrees should be there. Then only the loss of the reflection of loss will be exist. Next, second one, angle of incident, next angle of reflection or incident ray, next reflection ray, normal line and normal line should be at one plane. Okay, these are the two laws. What is the first one? Angle of incident is equal to angle of R. Second one, incident ray, reflection ray and normal line should be at one plane. These are the two laws of reflection. Next we will enter into the, okay, how to draw. Just till now we discuss about the plane mirror rays. Okay, now we are going to discuss the same rays in the spherical mirrors. Previously I discussed about only plane mirror. Now I am going to discuss rays, how the rays are traveling in the spherical mirrors. Spherical mirrors. Okay, spherical mirrors. Okay, previously we discussed only plane mirror. Now we are going to discuss spherical mirrors. Okay, how we can get the spherical mirrors? Okay, how we can get spherical mirrors means, now I am going to give some analogy to this. Now I am considering here one circle. Okay, that circle is nothing inside it. Then one sense we can say that is the allosphere. Okay, definitely this allosphere is the center part. In the mathematics, what we are calling this is the center. If I draw one line, what we can call this is radius. Okay, this side also will be there, radius. Okay, total distance, what we can add? Then diameter. Total how much here? From here to here, how much? D. D is equal to how much? R plus R. Then how much we are getting? 2R. Then D is equal to how much? What we can write? R is equal to how much we can write? D by 2. Like that we can get. Okay. But we won't discuss this one here. What we need actually? We need a spherical mirror. So first, what I want is spherical mirror where curved surface should be there. So for that purpose, this total allosphere as center point. What it is as? Center part is there. Okay, now what I am doing? Simply I am taking half of the sphere. How much I am taking? Only half I am taking. This. So this curve. Now what we can call this is? We should not call this is sphere. Now what we can call this is a curve. What we can call? Curve. Okay, the curve has center point. Okay, the center I am denoting with C letter. How I am denoting? C letter. Okay, this is related to mathematics. Now, when you come to the physics, okay, spherical mirrors in general, we can use, there are two types. How many types? Spherical mirror, we can divide into two types. There are many types are there. In our syllabus, only we are using two types. One is concave mirror. Another one is convex mirror. First one is concave mirror, second one is convex mirror. Okay, which one we can say concave mirror, which one we can say convex mirror. Okay, I got the curve. If I quoted outside of the curve, that we are calling the concave mirror. Okay, next one. What is the second one? Convex mirror. Same thing if you take, and if this also has center point, again here also has, it is also has center point. Okay, first one is completed, second one is convex. If you quoted inside of the curve, then we are calling this is the convex mirror. This is the main two types. One is concave mirror, another one is convex mirror. Okay, now we'll see how to draw the rays. See, why you have to draw means, this is the topic, ray optics. Optics means these are all optic instruments. Convex mirror, concave mirror, these are all optics. No, so I have to draw rays. Okay, how the image we are getting in the convex and concave mirror. First we'll discuss about the concave mirror, how the rays are coming and how the rays are reaching. Before that, I will tell about the concave mirror. This is the concave mirror. Just now I said, out, if it is outside quoted, then we can say that is the concave mirror. The concave mirror has center point. This dot we are calling in the physics center of curvature. What we are calling that is center of curvature. That is denoted by capital C. Okay, the curve also has center point. This point we are calling the pole. What are you calling? This point, pole. This point, center of curvature. Okay, if any line, okay, this point, center of curvature of this curve. Again, this curve has its own center. That we are calling the pole. If any line passes through the C and P. What is the C mean? Center of curvature and pole. If line is passing through the P and C, then we are calling this is principal axis. Principal axis. Center of curvature. Pole, center of curvature and principal axis. So, this point center of curvature, this point pole. Okay, mid another point is there, that we are calling focus. It is denoted by small f. This is small p, this is capital F, this is C. Okay, next another parameter is there. Next one, the distance between pole and focus, that we are calling small f. Small f means we can say focal length. Focal length. Okay, already I said previously the distance between pole to center of curvature at this point, how much I said, this is the total radius. This is the total radius that we can denote in the optics, either small r or capital R, no problem, you can denote. So focal length, what are the parameters we got? Pole, next one focal length, next one focus, next one center of curvature, next one radius. These are all very important parameters. When you are solving problems, you have to remember these points: pole, focus, neck, pole, focal length, focus, center of curvature, radius. Okay, this is mirror, these parts will be there. Okay, now I am considering source. If you want to see object, what you need? Definitely you need mirror as well as source also you need.